defense. And today I want to talk about a story where a woman tried to murder her husband. Now, her husband is 80% paralyzed because he had a stroke 8 years ago. And he found himself wrapped up in a blanket with a freaking paper bag or plastic bag over his head. She tried to do the plastic bag thing, man, and get him up out of there. For the last month or so, I have been talking about domestic violence, but I've also been talking about domestic violence against men, because that's something that's underreported, something that we don't really talk about. And men don't really talk about it when it happens to them. And sometimes, man, like I said, I had a buddy of mine. He got hit, tooth knocked out with the ironing board. But when the police came, they took him in instead of her in. But anyway, man, I digress. So this woman, she, you know, she's 55, 57 years old. She tries to kill her husband, who is 80% paralyzed, by putting a paper bag over his head. She had him wrapped up in blankets, but he was still able to fight her off. The thing is, she's not really a killer. You know, a lot of people are not really killers. And when they get to that point, they can't really do it well. But from a self-defense standpoint, even though this man was 80% paralyzed, he was probably totally, completely surprised and blindsided. He still fought. He didn't say, you know what, man, I'm 80% paralyzed. I'm not going to be able to fight back. I'm going to go ahead and take this L. And in this case, that L would have been his life. So he was able to fight her off. She leaves the room, I guess, to try to find some other form of murder or whatever. But he was able to get on the phone and call his sister. And she's the one that called the police and came through for him. And she's in jail now. Now, here's the thing. I don't know the backstory. Now, for me, there's no reason why she should have did that, you know. And I can only speculate on why she would have did that. Now, one reason is she was tired of taking care of him. She was tired of living that life. And she wanted the insurance money. All right. Another reason, it could have been on the flip side. I'm going to go ahead and play devil's advocate. He could have been mentally abusive to her. He could have been mentally abusive towards her. Now, here's the thing. I'm not trying to put nothing out there, man. I'm just sitting here talking about the story. It's an interesting story to me. It's a story where a person had to defend himself. It's a domestic violence situation where it was a domestic violence against a man. And so I'm